6, environmentalists are taking on the state over the Santa Susana site west of Canoga Park and once home to one of the nation's biggest nuclear accidents. Environmentalists claim buildings there are still contaminated by radiation, and demolishing them could put people at risk. Here's NBC4's Michelle Vias.
Warren, where and how did you get your hands on that 20-year-old film of the accident?
It was 1979 when a KNBC investigation uncovered a partial reactor meltdown occurred at the Santa Susana Field Laboratory. That accident was hidden from the public for more than 20 years.
81 pieces of uranium fuel scattered around on the bottom of the core.
The contamination turned out to be extensive.
The thing is, people say, well, why don't you move?
Barbara Johnson is one of the four activists who has lived down the hill from the plant since the 70s. The group, who has all developed cancer or leukemia, was successful in shutting down nuclear operations in the 90s.
We thought the damage had been done, and they were going to be, you know, careful with this cleanup, that there wouldn't be any further pollution, but here they are.
With the demolition.
It is not okay. It is illegal.
Watchdog groups have now filed suit after the State Department of Toxic Substance Control gave Boeing permission to demolish some of the buildings and is considering allowing more demolition by the end of the year. In the suit, environmental groups claim some of those buildings still show levels of radioactivity. The group says the state should hold public hearings and produce an environmental impact report.
We have some of the most stringent laws in the nation on environmental protection. Our problem is the DTSC does not enforce them.
In a lawsuit, the plaintiffs allege testing done for the EPA shows levels of some types of radiation are well above what naturally occurs in the environment. But a spokesperson for DTSC told us experts from EPA have determined buildings set for demolition later this year are free of any contamination. In a statement, the agency says none of the buildings or materials demolished and disposed of poses a risk to public health or the environment. They go on to say they're reviewing other buildings on the site to see if they remain contaminated.
There is no such thing as a safe level of radioactive contamination. You cannot be a little radioactive, just like you cannot be a little pregnant.
And that was Michelle Vias reporting. Now, Boeing tells NBC4 it's complying with all state and federal laws and is committed to clean the site to a level it says will be 10 times safer than what's required.